I'm going to, yeah, I want to just go in and really explain the journey that I've had over the last 2 years at Companies for Zero Waste, and just really how the business has grown in the last 2 years, where we're headed, and where I see things moving forward, and having so many wonderful intellectual people that are driven to make a difference in the environment and get it and understand it and are willing to put in the really hard work. That's what Companies for Zero Waste is about. I don't think there's just one magical solution there. On my journey over the last 2 years, I started the company. One of my friends has a composting business in New Jersey. And I started doing some research and found that there are over 400 dormant landfills just in the state where I live. And reaching out and making phone calls, found out that the average distance to move waste in 2001, which wasn't that long ago, was about 90 to 100 miles. And now it's up to 700 miles to transport that waste. So my question was, what's happening to all this waste? Is it going to the Midwest? What is happening here? And what I found was reaching out to corporations, reaching out to even policymakers in this area, trying to get them on board Wall Street, intersecting all of the key decision makers is a very daunting task. But circularity is really the key component to this is getting people in different sectors to be transparent with their supply chain and share the failures that they have with these incubator programs. Out of reaching out to many Fortune 5000 companies, and many are very open, but the AB InBevs, the DuPonts, the companies out there, the ADSs, that are willing to talk about not just their successes, but what are the challenges that they're having in the incubator programs, and getting these very smart, intelligent engineers and people together to educate the sustainability directors, the supply chain directors, giving an education over to the investment banks. It's a wonderful opportunity for all of us to come together. And our motto is words are good, actions are better. So we want to create a plan between each of our meetings, an action plan to solve specific problems, and then to come back and really understand where we want to go and create metrics over the next few years. So that's really what our vision is about. One of the challenges too, reaching out to corporations, is that it doesn't fit into their wheelhouse if it's not in their sector. However, as you know, oil and gas industry, healthcare, education, all these manufacturing companies, it's all tied in holistically to moving towards zero waste. And the wonderful news over the last 10 months with the lockdown is our business has moved from 90% domestic, and it's about 65 to 70% domestic and about 30% global now, and it's growing. So we're really excited to have everyone join us. And it's very important for people, again, to share their ideas, get the message out there, and really fail forward. And that's what we want to do. So I would highly recommend, jumping on our website, taking a look at what we're doing. The renewable energy infrastructure is a really big passion for me as well right now, because we're putting so much into rebuilding the grid. People are working together. I have reached out to some major companies that are in EV, working on infrastructure. Some of them don't want to deal with circularity. They don't understand it. So it's really a matter of education. And our goal together with leaders like yourself, and I see this in the next 2 or 3 years, is that we will have Zoom meetings with CEOs. We'll have a few hundred CEOs on the phone learning about this, because there are huge profit margins that can be captured by looking at these critical raw materials as a resource and catching these critical raw materials early on in the supply chain. And I've learned from the beginning too, recycling isn't the answer necessarily. Waste to energy is being used to hit the 90% mark for zero waste. So companies that can't hit it are secretly incinerating, and not to vilify them, but we can do better than this. We can do much better through innovation, through collaboration, and just driving things forward. And that's really the message that I wanted to give out to all the audience. So thank you, Deborah.